My name's Doug Jones. I'm a consultant sports physiotherapist here at MIP. I work alongside the consultants that work here, and we offer multidisciplinary team services where in any one time we might have a physio, sports medicine doctor, consultant working together to diagnose an injury that a boxer might be suffering from, because we understand the pressure they're under to get back training and fighting as quickly as possible. We also have recovery facilities, strength and conditioning facilities, where we can help boxers recover from training midweek or after a fight. Or we have facilities, obviously, where we can rehabilitate boxers from any injuries they get. So what we've been working on there is isolating Terry's strength in the back of his shoulder. What we see in boxers is they're very, very strong at the front of their shoulder, and what we call their antagonistic muscles at the back are much, much weaker. This piece of equipment we've got here is a Kaiser machine, and it's a very, very accurate way to measure strength and also to rehabilitate strength. And the setup we've got, we're able to isolate Terry so he can't use the rest of his body, which is really strong. And we found that his left shoulder is about 50% weaker in the back, and that means that he gets pain and he gets tightness. So what we've done today is we've measured the weakness, and we're going to load it now in a specific position, isolate the muscle, improve his strength, and that will hopefully take away some of the symptoms in his ribcage and in the muscles that control the back of his shoulder.
My pushing muscles, like my front side of my shoulder, is a lot stronger than the back, so I'll need to start doing more work on the back to even it out, and then the muscles won't be as tight. It seems like these muscles are bigger than the back muscles, so it's pulling on my muscles and making them worse. Is that right?
Yeah, because of what you do, the amount of force you generate, sometimes it's 5 times body weight when you hit something really hard. The joint has to stay central. If it doesn't, it can cause pain and tightness. It can stretch the muscles and joints in the back and pinch at the front. So naturally, he's going to get very, very tight in his chest and his biceps and the front part of his shoulder, and use them a lot to do the pressing type activity, the punch that he's doing. So for every punch he's got to do, he's got to marry that up with a rotation or a pullback. And if they don't do that, then they start to get this inherent weakness in the back, and that causes the instability and that causes the pain. Treatment's essential. The only way we're going to undo the tightness is through soft tissue and stretching. So we'll teach Terry some stretches to do for his chest and biceps, and then encourage him to get soft tissue once a week to recover from the punishment of repeatedly boxing. And then we've said 2 times a week he should strengthen the back to try and counteract all the repetitive punch work that he's doing.
The punching side of it, that's what I'm quite stiff and forward. I need to work the back so I can balance it out, as you say.
Yeah, and it will increase your power, and it will make you less at risk of all these.
It's surprising that my left hand's my strongest arm, and it's 50% weaker than
What you probably do, because of your ability to punch and the talent that you've got, you use other parts of your body at the expense of your shoulder to create power. So think of it this way: you're creating lots of power with a weak shoulder.
Imagine how strong I'll be.
Exactly, yeah.
With a good strong shoulder.